we decided to take our kids to Disney World for my 40th birthday. We did 5 days straight with all three of our kids, and it was a mistake. We love our kids.
We do love our kids, but they're teenagers, so, you know. It's always more fun when it's just the two of us.
So we ditched the kids. I don't know why we didn't think of this until the end of the trip.
Seriously, I don't know.
We just all of a sudden realized that they're 16, 14, and 12. Yeah. Like, it just dawned on us, like, wait a minute. Why do we have to do everything with them? So the last 2 hours of the trip, we were like, you guys go do whatever you want.
Yeah.
Tell us your plan so we know where to find
you. They had a phone. They texted us like right. 5 seconds.
And we let them go. We just said, leave us alone.
I just don't know why we didn't think of it until now.
Yep, they're gone. So we're going to go do whatever we want. It's funny because we rode one ride and sat and talked.
Right. But I mean, like, that's like going back to the beginning for us.
The old college days, we would go, because the park was only 15, 20 minutes from school, we would go eat dinner, ride two rides, and then right. just sit there and talk.
We both worked there. We got in for free. We just would just be together.
I would just take in your beauty while we
oh
sat there.
Oh my gosh. You're such a dork.
Day one, officially at Disney World, and we're headed to breakfast. Hey, Nicholas, how are you there, pal?
Hey.
Addie's with me as well. We're staying at the Art of Animation, and we're headed to the breakfast area to get our Mickey-shaped waffles.
One thing that I really liked about this trip was getting to try these new things that they added, like Toy Story Land and Galaxy's Edge and Avatar, all these new things they added since last time I was there.
We hopped off the plane and went straight to the water park. We went to Blizzard Beach.
These slides were scary. It's like straight down. I'm like, oh my gosh!
Very fun. Lots of slides, lots of steps. Gotta walk a lot.
We really liked Typhoon Lagoon better, but it was closed.
So we stayed at the Art of Animation, which is pretty far from the parks, but one of the benefits of that resort is that it's connected to the Skyliner, and we did not know how much we were gonna love the Skyliner.
The Skyliner is like our new favorite thing to do, especially as old folks.
It's a gondola that takes you from a couple of the hotels to a couple of the parks. Mm-hmm. It's not all interconnected, but we loved it.
It's just like a nice breeze and it's quiet and I don't know.
And there's no music, there's nothing. Like, it's just peace and quiet with like a little breeze.
The second day we went to Epcot and I liked Test Track.
My favorite thing at Epcot is definitely Test Track.
I loved Soarin', Test Track, and then Frozen Ever After.
If I can only ride one ride at Epcot, it would probably be Frozen Ever After.
The new Frozen ride surprised me. I did not think I would like that because I'm kind of several years over the movie, but it was still a cool ride.
Yeah, no, it was fun.
Yeah, that was good. End of day two, where we started at Epcot and ended at, what is this place?
Hollywood Studios.
Hollywood Studios, so that Nicholas could buy a lightsaber.
Day three was the best day out of all of them.
It's the Magic Kingdom, which is my 40th birthday.
Yep.
And I kind of overhear you like basically putting the kids in line because it's Dad's birthday and they better not ruin it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they were the best behaved that day, so whatever you said to them worked.
We are going to Magic Kingdom today. Woo! And Dad, how do you feel?
I feel good. I feel old.
It's Dad's birthday.
Yeah. Happy birthday, Dad.
Yes.
So we got our pictures out of the way, and then we know that part.
Yeah.
I mean, we know it so well. We know exactly what to do when the lines are gonna be the shortest, when they're gonna be the longest.
We are park pros. We got 16 rides in 11 hours.
If I could only ride one ride in Magic Kingdom, it would probably be the Buzz Lightyear Ranger Spin.
Well, you know, the older we get, the more I like the slow rides, so. I used to live for Space Mountain. Now Space Mountain just gives me a headache.
One time on Space Mountain and I was like, hey, let's all sit down for an hour.
Yeah.
My favorite there was either Space Mountain or Splash Mountain. I love all of the mountains.
Splash Mountain is still my
Splash Mountain. Yeah,
is
Splash
still
Mountain
my favorite.
We did that a couple times.
I got completely soaked, even though I was in the third row.
Got all the kids on Haunted Mansion this year.
I had to ride the Haunted Mansion. I hated it. Everyone else loved it.
We actually met up with Greg and Emily were there because they saw it on Facebook, so they're our friends, and they saw that we were there on Facebook, and they were there. So we ended up meeting up with them and riding Mansion with them.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Animal Kingdom was the day that I know you were looking forward to probably the most. Not because Animal Kingdom is your favorite park.
No, it is not.
But it has your favorite attraction.
Yes, it does. Flight of Passage. The first time we went, I was deathly afraid, but now I'm kind of over my fear of heights and I love it. I'm like, another dive bomb! But yeah, I told the kids, I'm like, y'all don't know it yet, but we're gonna ride this like 4 times today.
And we did.
Yeah.
Three times.
We rode it 3 times. But yeah, it was amazing. And I think at one point I heard Addie, like the first time we went, like in the middle of the ride, just yelling like, this is amazing. So it was awesome. Everybody loved it.
If I could ride one ride in Animal Kingdom, it would probably be Avatar Flight of Passage.
We went on Avatar Flight of Passage and it was the best thing ever.
The lines were surprisingly long. I don't know if I was expecting because of just the way the park's been limited capacity, I was expecting like 20 minute waits. There were 20 minute waits, but for the most part, like that ride had a 90 minute plus wait.
Yeah, that was like almost 2 hours.
Right, yeah. A lot of them had a long wait. Animal Kingdom, we kind of cut that day short just because we like animals and we like Animal Kingdom, but it's just not our park for some reason.
No, it's confusing a bit when you don't know the land, and right. It was really hot that day. Kind of gave
the hottest day,
migraine.
I think.
Yeah.
Well, I rode Everest with the kids.
Yeah, which, that was a mistake.
Which was a huge mistake for me and 2 out of the 3 kids. Addie and I did not like Everest. We are over that.
Smart and never wrote it.
That was the day we had to go back and take a nap. Because I'm like, hun, we've done Flight of Passage 3 times and Everest. Like, I have to go lay down. Oh, 40.
Yeah. Dad's an old man now.
Flight of Passage, I would say, is probably the most immersive attraction experience Friday morning, we got in the virtual queue for Rise of the Resistance. Got a virtual queue pass for Rise of Resistance. We're gonna do it in about an hour.
You can't even call it a ride.
No.
It's amazing.
The most immersive, jaw-dropping experience I've ever had in a theme park, for sure.
Yeah.
It was so cool. It felt like you were in the movies. It's my overall favorite ride.
You're not even a huge Star Wars person.
I'm not, no.
Like, what was it about it for you that was so good?
I mean, you just felt like you were in the movie. Like, everything was, like, to scale size-wise, the amount of detail. It was really good. It was amazing.
Smuggler's Run, it was so realistic. And I was up front piloting, and I got to make that jump to light speed. We just went, zoom, and it was so cool. I loved it.
At the Droid Depot, we got to build a droid. So then, like, when you're done, the guy gives you a remote, and then you stick it in with your droid in this little bucket thing, and then it powers up, and you can buy, like, boosters and the personality chip.
It's, like, so much fun, like, when it gets kind of, like, activating it the first time.
It was really great getting to spend Dad's birthday and getting to do something really fun, like Disney World.
This is gonna take some thought, but I wanna count down your 5 favorite things. So 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're counting back down.
Is like the best? When is the best?
Yeah.
These are my top 5 things at Disney World.
My top 5 favorite things at Disney World are...
Number 5. There was this hilarious squirrel. Over by where we were at was a stand selling these cinnamon-covered almonds.
Yep.
That's what it wanted. It wanted the almonds, and it would sit there and eat them, and it was cute. Okay, that's number 5.
Number 5 is the Disney Skyliner.
Number 5 is Pandora's Flight, which was really fun.
Number 5, either Splash Mountain or Space Mountain. Can't make a decision.
My top 5 favorite things from this trip at Disney World were number 5, the People Mover. I love the People Mover.
My 4th favorite was the Carousel of Progress.
Number 4 is Wizard Beach.
Number 4 was Splash Mountain, which we finished on, and I loved it. Last ride at the last park on the last day is, of course,
Splash Mountain.
Splash Mountain.
Number 4, Smuggler's Run.
Number 4 was just being able to spend your 40th together at the park with the kids. That was awesome.
Number 3 is Rise of Resistance.
Number 3, Avatar, Flight of Passage.
Number 3 is probably those 2 hours that we spent together at the end, our last night there. It was fun.
My 3rd favorite is Small World.
Number 3 was Flight of Passage. Number 2 was the Skyliner. I don't know why, but it's just so good. It's like you called it the new and improved People Mover.
Yeah.
Which People Mover was number 5. It's great.
Number 2 is Buying My Own Lightsaber.
My 2nd favorite is the Mickey's Short Vacation Fun.
Number two, Rise of Resistance. Number two is Flight of Passage. That's always been number one, but now number one is Rise of Resistance.
Number one was Avatar Flight of Passage.
And number one is Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railroad.
Number one, the food, of course.
And number one, my absolute favorite thing from this trip was being with Erika. No. Was Rise of the Resistance. I genuinely got you on that one, didn't I?